My name is Raj Gonzai. I've got a practice in Weymouth Street in the Harley Street district of London. How did I first become interested in dentistry? So my first interest in dentistry was really almost accidental. I kind of fell into the trade as an undergraduate. My father's a doctor, I'm third generation medic. I knew that I didn't want to go into medicine, having had the experience, and I always enjoyed working with my hands, so I thought I'd try dentistry. And from there, really, I just fell in love with it. I've always had a general love of restorative dentistry, and that really is quite a wide gambit, and it goes from simple restorative work all the way to rehabilitating complex cases. We found this site in April of 2014, and we had to make the choice as to whether we were going to develop this site or stay on and see what happened at the old site. Luckily, we took the plunge. It took us a year to get this far. Yeah. We're happy with how far we've got. It's a beautiful site, but there's still plenty to do. It was a real bomb site, actually. It was dark wooden floors, picture rails in completely the wrong place. It really needed a lot of development. At the point at which we started to redevelop, I was talking to three different supplying groups who were keen on providing designs and developing my surgical sites. The introduction to RPA and PEEK came through a colleague of mine who's actually upstairs now. He's the lab technician upstairs, and he said that having heard from a couple of people who were dealing with my sites that I should meet Pete. And so we met, and Pete had a real vision. He made me feel quite comfortable with what was quite a large project to take on. And I felt that I was floundering a bit when I first started. I had quite a clear idea of what I wanted. We had a surgery that had been established for a long time, which worked quite well. However, needed a complete revamp. So we knew where things needed to be and how we were going to develop surgical sites and different aspects of dentistry, especially offering different specialities within, say, a room like this. It was about designing how you wanted the layout to be able to suit all of those specialities and still fall within the realms of somewhere that you as a practitioner wanted to work in on a daily basis. So Pete was very easygoing with the design. He said, you have a look and see how you want things to be and give me an idea and I'll start drawing up some plans for you. And we started off with a global template, which we then started focusing on down to handles and tray inserts. And so it was a nice gradual way it evolved, which is, I think, the best way to do it, really. A lot of the other practices in the area have real problems because they're not quite what they wanted to be after having spent 9 months developing them. We knew that as we were taking over a building as opposed to a floor where my suite was situated, it would give me the scope to expand my capabilities and move from a one surgery suite to offering three different surgeries, which I could cater to the patients, really, as opposed to sending things out. We had specialties visiting us, and patients just prefer it. It's a nicer way to be able to control the experience that the patient has and liaise with specialists so that you've got a global view of what the patient needs and try and achieve those aims. So we offer various arrangements with different specialists who come and use rooms like this on a rental basis. We also have specialists who cover the fields that we used to refer out to come and visit us. We have a periodontist visiting us, we have an endodontist visiting us, we have microscope capabilities that we didn't have before. It also allows me a dedicated site to be able to provide more complex implant surgeries, which we didn't quite have with the old surgical site. The old surgical site was based on a practice which was handcrafted in the 70s. Beautiful molded sculpting wood, but it didn't quite allow us the modern presence to be able to offer most of the modern things in terms of practice that you would expect today. So everything's designed within the actual framework of the drawers and the way that we've arranged mobile units or larger units to hide things like the impression machine and the capsule mixing machine. There was a lot of thought guided by Pete actually on how things would be best arranged. We started off with a plan developed by my nurse. He came in and he said to my nurse, where do you put things? What kind of drawers do you like? What do you need to put away? And from there, we just started designing how things would best fit overall to work around the practitioner and the assistant. I think the effort to try and keep the characteristics of each room has really paid off. There are other practices where these features have been covered over, as you say, they get boarded over, and then it starts to look like a clinic. You start to lose all of the character, apart from the ceilings, from the room, which I think is a shame because in themselves the rooms are beautiful. I'm very happy with what's happened here. I think the project design and the project leadership that Pete took on was exceptional. So would I have done something differently? No, I don't think. I'm quite content in where I am.